the US and China have the two most advanced stealth fighter jets in the world, the F-22 Raptor and the J-20 Mighty Dragon. But which one is better in combat? We're going to break down the balance of power. Hi, I'm Sam Fellman. I'm a defense editor at Business Insider, and I'm a US Navy veteran. To think about why we're comparing these jets, we need to step back to the Ukraine war. The Ukraine war is showing us the power of air defense systems. Any aircraft that can be radar detected within a missile range can be shot down. That's large drones, fighters of all kinds. Ukraine has lost Su-27 air superiority fighters. Russia has lost Su-34 fighter bombers, just as two examples. So fairly sophisticated jets are being shot down by air defenses. An air superiority fighter's role is to knock out air defenses and enemy fighters before they can be spotted. So a fifth generation fighter is the answer to this problem of pervasive and dangerous air defense systems. It's designed to fly fast and to go undetected, or to be minimally detected and to be able to achieve its missions of perhaps destroying enemy fighters and destroying enemy air defenses before it can be detected and engaged. The F-22 is the most advanced air-to-air fighter ever built. We don't really know that much about the J-20. It's an enigmatic aircraft. We only know a little bit from Chinese sources and then from what are essentially guesstimates. And so the ranges and much else are really best understood as round figures. The J-20 is China's answer to the F-22 Raptor. US officials have accused China of stealing defense technology writ large, and they've specifically accused China of stealing technology to build the J-20, their first stealth fighter. It costs north of $100 million. Estimates range, there's no credible single figure. The J-20 entered service in 2017, and China is estimated to have over 200 operational. Stealth is the ability to avoid detection. It requires precision engineering of the highest order on every aspect of the plane. Its door access panels, its undercarriage of the fuselage and the flat panels on its wings, the helmet on the pilot's head. Everything the plane is designed to have is few aspects that protrude from the stealth exterior as possible to minimize the return of radio waves. Comparing the stealth of the aircraft is really a guessing game. But stealth is the most critical factor that defines the fifth generation aircraft. A fast fifth generation aircraft can be detected, can be shot down, just like a fourth generation aircraft. And so the advance, the potential inherent in the fifth generation aircraft is that perhaps it won't be spotted. We can certainly ascertain that the J-20 has stealth features and some similarities with the F-22. The F-22 also has delta wing shape, and they both have angled vertical stabilizers. The angled vertical stabilizers are one element of the plane's designed to minimizing its radar signature. One of the big differences between the F-22 and the J-20 is the J-20 has these little wings called canards. They are just behind the cockpit and provide more lift. Stealth is primarily measured in observable technologies. For an aircraft, that means infrared as well as radar returns. This comes down to either radar absorbing or radar transparent materials, think like plastic, that are on the aircraft that limit the bounce back of radio waves to a receiver. It is that that creates the radar return an air defense crew is using to scan the skies and look for enemy aircraft. And so a fifth gen fighter is a fighter designed to have a very tiny, easily mistook radar signature, much smaller than an aircraft like the F-22 that's 62 feet long and has a wingspan of 44 feet. By some accounts, it may have the radar return the size of a marble. Infrared sensors could detect a fifth generation fighter, but most surface-to-air missile systems need a radar return to lock on to the target. The F-22, designed by Lockheed Martin, is believed to have a very small radar cross-section, or RCS. Another possibility is to have something that almost like deadens the radio energy. Or if it does send back a wave, it puts the waves together so that they're coming from one common angle versus having lots of different angles. That's one reason that a stealth fighter tends to have angles that are all the same across the airplane, across different features of the airplane. It's to try to minimize the amount of surfaces that are returning. To sort of specific angles to make sure that there's this radar absorbing fill in any access panel, and that there's also coatings on the aircraft more generally to try to minimize its signature. If even three small screws were to be protruding from anywhere in the aircraft, those could create a larger radar return than the entire rest of the aircraft that's been coated and treated with the radar absorbing materials. Beyond the ability to evade radar detection, the most important features are weapons range and accuracy. The F-22 has better maneuverability than the J-20. The F-22 has superior engines. From what we've seen of the few public appearances of the J-20, it's fairly unimpressive maneuvers compared to other air superiority fighters. Maneuverability is not super important for modern air-to-air fighters. Most air-to-air battles are happening beyond visual range. Today's pilots don't need to point at the specific target in order to launch a missile, and those missiles have long ranges, often beyond the pilot's visual range. That's meant that the weapon's accuracy and the weapon's range, as well as the ability to avoid detection, are the critical qualities for a modern air superiority fighter. The J-20 is a slightly larger aircraft. When it comes to payload, the J-20 appears to have more internal carrying capacity. The J-20 is able to carry the PL-15 air-to-air missile. It's a beyond visual range missile that can reach targets up to 190 miles away, and it has an active radar seeker. The F-22 carries two types of missiles. One is the AMRAAM, that's the Advanced Medium Range Air-to-Air Missile. This is a mainstay U.S. Fighter weapon. It's been proven in combat for three decades. The AMRAAM costs about $1 million each, and it can reach targets about 100 miles away. The AIM-9 is another important U.S. air defense weapon. It's a shorter range missile with a heat-seeking warhead, and it costs about $400,000 each. Missiles are the leading threat to aircraft. Missiles and radars can detect most enemy aircraft, and a fifth-gen aircraft designates a type of very state-of-the-art fighter that's designed to defeat and fool those systems. U.S. fighter engine technology has been one of China's top espionage priorities. The F-22's engines have been in use for decades and are vastly more reliable than anything China currently has. The Pratt & Whitney engines allow the F-22 to fly supersonic. Why is Super Cruise important? Super Cruise is the ability to fly at a supersonic speed without using an afterburner. An afterburner has two problems. One is that it guzzles fuel, meaning that it is rapidly depleting the amount of fuel that the aircraft carries, and that means that a pilot can't fly an afterburner for very long. Typically, it's just used in short bursts, not as a cruise speed. The secondary problem is an afterburner creates more of an observable tail. That tail is detectable both via radar and via infrared because of the heat energy it's putting off. So a stealth aircraft that has Super Cruise has major fuel and stealth advantages over one that does not. It appears that the J-20 has a larger internal fuel capacity, up to 26,000 pounds stored internally. Fuel is important, but the engines are pretty different from each other. China doesn't have reliable engines yet that allow the J-20 to supercruise. Building jet engines requires very advanced design and materials. And China has struggled to build engines on the really high end that are needed for an air superiority fighter, both for maneuvering and for supercruise. The J-20 is no match for the F-22. The US Air Force says the F-22 cannot be matched by any known or projected aircraft, and there's good reason to believe that's not a boast. The F-22 has superior engines that can supercruise, therefore moving at a fast speed with less ability to be detected, and US stealth technology is a proven and operational technology. The Chinese have advanced air defenses and a fifth generation fighter in the J-20, but if a F-22 cannot be detected before it carries out its missions, then those defenses are defanged. The J-20 may be an effective air-to-air fighter against the US's fourth generation fighters like the F-15 and the F-16. The J-20 may not need to match the F-22 to be useful. China's goal may be maintaining air superiority over its mainland and its surface-to-air missiles, and the J-20 fighter give it a shot at doing that. Thanks to stealth and superior engines, the balance of power goes to the F-22.